Good morning. Or I should say good afternoon. Welcome to the 2023 African Land Forces Summit here at the Sofitel in Abidjan, Côte d'Ivoire. Thank you for your attendance. Today's ceremony launches the 11th African Land Forces Summit, co-hosted by the United States and its African partners. This year's theme is addressing security challenges through civil-military partnerships. This summit provides land force commanders a platform to discuss common threats and challenges while simultaneously strengthening partnerships and developing new relationships. We are excited to co-host this year's event in Abidjan with our Ivorian partners and look forward to the discussions throughout the week. We would like to graciously welcome back past participants, and we have coordinated subject matter experts to provide keynote addresses. We hope this facilitates building new partnerships, strengthening others, and collaborating for a better future. Among many distinguished guests with us today, I'm honored to welcome members of the diplomatic corps, the press, senior government officials, and general officers. It is now my honor to introduce our official party. The Ivorian Minister of Defense, the Honorable Téné Ouattara, the Chief of the Defense Staff for the Armed Forces, Lieutenant General Lassina, Doumbia, the Chief of Staff for the Ivorian Army, Major General Justin Ali Dem, the American Ambassador to Cote d'Ivoire, the Honorable Jessica Davis Baugh, the Commanding General, United States Army Europe and Africa, General Darryl A. Williams, the Command Sergeant Major, the United States Army Europe and Africa, Command Sergeant Major Jeremiah E. Inman, the Deputy Commanding General, United States Army Southern European Task Force, Africa, Brigadier General Brian T. Cashman, the Command Sergeant Major, United States Army Southern European Task Force, Africa, Command Sergeant Major Reese W. Teakell. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the arrival of the official party and remain standing for the playing of the Ivorian and American national anthems, followed by the invocation. Thank you.
Mes frères et mes sœurs, nous allons confier ce sommet.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to pray for this conference in the name of the Son, the Father, the Holy Spirit. May the Lord be with you. Lord, Master of Time, Master of History, Master of Armies, may you give us the opportunity to brainstorm together today to find solutions for the security and safety of our land. We pray, O Lord, inspire every decision that we make for peace, for unity, for safety and security. We would like to repeat the prayer your Son, Jesus Christ, taught us. We would like to say this prayer as brothers with faith. Together we say, Our Lord, Father in heaven, may your name be sanctified, may your reign come, may your will be done on earth. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive our sins as we forgive those who have committed offense towards us. Deliver us from evil, because you are the master of power, glory for centuries and centuries. May the Lord bless these deliberations in the name of the Son, the Father, and the Holy Spirit.
Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Chers frères, chers sœurs, que la paix.
Dear brothers and friends, we pray that peace be with you. The work that you are doing, this is a work of army, and this is a work which started long ago, since King Solomon. And this work is full of requirements. The Prophet Salam says, Ailani, this is in Arabic. This means two categories of people who never know about the story. And he says, the one whose eyes have watched the others is at the forefront, and you are the one ensuring safety and security, and your work is blessed, because the Prophet says, for this to be blessed, you need to be respectful, compliant, and do this job with the fear of God and have respect for the hierarchy. This is why you are all blessed, and we pray for you, for this work you are doing in West Africa, for the security and safety of the people. This job has to be done in compliance with the hierarchies that you imposed on yourself. May God bless your job, and may God give you a peaceful end.
صلي سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون والصلاة والسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته que la paix de Dieu soit avec vous.
May the peace of God be with you.
Thank you. Please be seated. At this time, I would like to wish a warm welcome to our summit co-organizers and ask them to please stand. General Dem and General Cashman, could you please stand for a moment? Thank you, gentlemen. It is now my honor to introduce Colonel Ocello, Ivorian Army.
Monsieur le ministre d'État, ministre de la Défense, Madame l'ambassadeur de...
Honorable Minister, Your Excellency Ambassador of U.S. in Côte d'Ivoire, dear Chief of Staff of Côte d'Ivoire Armies, dear General, U.S. and Europe Force Commander, ladies and gentlemen, dear Chief of Staff of Land Forces, General Officers, High Rank Officers, dear Participant and Expert of Security Issues, dear ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, dear friends of the media, the definition of modern conflict establishes three atmospheric areas, all defended by all type of armies. The air forces are fighting in support of land forces or in preparation of the land forces entry. Navy sometimes denies access. Land is at the heart of conquest issues in modern conflicts. For the merit of actors in charge of the defense, there are 40 these high rank officials in charge of land forces coming from the entire Africa, not skipping Europe and America. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 11th summit of Land Forces Summit in Côte d'Ivoire for 5 days, and the topic is to take up the security issues thanks to the civilian and military partnership. For this afternoon, essentially, the agenda is highlighting three keynote speeches and an inaugural conference to open up the remarks series. I would like to call on the infantry high rank officials whose methodic orientation to the chief of staff contributed to shape the land forces of Côte d'Ivoire, which is today an example when it comes to international commitments, where it supplies most of the contingents. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to call on the General, Major General Mali Ali Dem, Chief of Staff of Army of Côte d'Ivoire. Honorable Minister of State, Minister of Defense of Côte d'Ivoire, Her Excellency, Madam U.S. Ambassador to the Republic of Côte d'Ivoire, Lieutenant General, Chief of Staff of the Côte d'Ivoire Armed Forces, Army General Commander of the U.S. Forces for Europe and Africa, Major General Commander of the U.S. Army Southern Europe Task Force for Africa, dear colleagues, general officers and senior officers, chief of staff of the land forces of respective armies, dear colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, general officers, senior officers, distinguished guests, all protocol observed. It's a great honor to stand before you in this solemn occasion and address this opening of an international summit of defense issues. The venue, the attendees, and the importance and relevance of the topic, which is meeting security challenges through civil-military partnership, and the various issues which will be discussed, make this summit a key event in the new security landscape. And we are proud to have Côte d'Ivoire as host of this 11th African Land Forces Summit. I would like, therefore, on behalf of the Lieutenant General, Chief of Staff of the Armed Forces of Côte d'Ivoire, extend a cordial greeting to each of you as you set foot on the Ivorian land. The convening of this summit, which addresses a concern shared by many of our countries, provides us an opportunity to brainstorm the prospective thinking which will generate the support in our operations. I want to express my gratitude to the U.S. Army, particularly its SETAF units, for conceiving and continually adjusting the summit's format and theme to match the evolving security situation in Africa. Thank you, United States of America, for entrusting Cote d'Ivoire with this critical summit. I would like to thank His Excellency, the President of the Republic, for the institutional support provided to the Ivorian Organizing Committee throughout the preparation process of these meetings. I also thank the Senior Minister and Minister of Defense for their trust in our capabilities and for providing valuable guidance. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests and fellow land forces commanders, we have a significant responsibility over the next 5 days here in Cote d'Ivoire. The conclusions of this summit will be closely scrutinized and eagerly anticipated. We need, therefore, to devise innovative, practical, and immediately implementable solutions that enhance the relationship between the military and the nation regarding human and collective security. We have designed this agenda with the goal in mind and must make the most of these opportunities for reflection. Beyond these discussions, we must also establish a network of like-minded military leaders with diverse security challenges, united in our goal to provide high-quality security to our population, institutions, and territories. From Abidjan, the birthplace of the fruitful collaboration of 40 African leaders, I would like to close my statement with this quoting from a famous radio channel: united to build is to grow together, because when in countries we have individual responsive, union becomes difficult. Fruitful deliberations, and I wish you a nice day in Cote d'Ivoire. Thank you. To introduce the next speaker, I'd like to hand over to Colonel Kopp.
Mesdames, Monsieur,
Commanding General of the United States Army Europe and Africa, General Darryl A. Williams.
Thank you and merci. Ambassador Davis Ba, thank you for all your support. Minister Ouattara, Your Excellency, is a great that you're able to join us here today, sir. Thank you. Generals Doumbia, Dim, thank you for your hospitality and for co-hosting ALFS. It's a great pleasure to return to Africa to visit your great country. I'd also like to thank you all for making the journey to be here, to join in this conversation. We have a fantastic level of attendance here from all across Africa and beyond. I'm a great believer in mission command and nesting my approach within my commander's intent. So I'm going to start by quoting the President of the United States at the Africa Leaders Summit last December. President Biden said that African voices, African leadership, African innovation are all critical to addressing the most pressing global challenges. To work with you on the issues that matter most to people's lives, to increase our collaboration in every area. That commitment is intended to help deliver in the long term, to achieve our collective vision for Africa in the future. Of course, I'm speaking of Africa, but I recognize that every country represented by the chiefs here today on the continent are all different, have their own objectives, their own priorities, their own identity. That's the power of sessions like this. The opportunity to listen to varied perspectives and experiences, to discuss how we can best work together, travailler ensemble, how we can best address challenges. We have a great theme for this conference, addressing security challenges through civil-military partnerships. But it's easier said than done. But I know that together we can learn from each other's experiences and identify ways to succeed, which we must, because we face no shortage of challenges. But as Secretary Blinken said when he visited Ethiopia in March, African-led solutions are increasingly making the difference in the challenges of the 21st century. Comprehensive, whole-of-government solutions, solutions which include elements of diplomacy, development, and defense, intertwine in a mutually supporting way. As President Biden, Secretary Blinken, Secretary Austin, and General Langley, my immediate boss, and I have all said, the United States stands ready to help, and helping we are. Under the strategy to prevent conflict and promote stability, we're supporting West African countries to enhance security force responsiveness and accountability to at-risk communities. In Sudan, we are encouraging both parties in the current conflict to negotiate an end to the violence, which is causing human suffering on a massive scale throughout Sudan and the region. In Libya, we're encouraging progress towards a civilian-controlled, unified military and security apparatus with a monopoly on the legitimate use of force, capable of maintaining stability and contributing to regional security. In the Sahel, we have the U.S. Department of State, USAID, and DOD committed $60 million to the Trans-Saharan Counterterrorism Partnership. In Somalia, we're supporting enabling counterterrorism forces. A key element of these initiatives is inclusivity, making sure that women play an active role in preventing and mitigating violence. Part of inclusivity is listening to all voices. That includes our enlisted soldiers. We highlighted the role of the non-commissioned officer during last year's summit and last September's colloquium. It's great to see so many of our senior enlisted leaders here today, and we look forward to deepening the dialogue on this very important topic over the next few days. Empowered enlisted leadership is critical to confronting the era's defining global peace, security, and governance challenges. I know how much I've relied on good NCOs throughout my career. Whether collaborating on shared priorities, training, equipping, or building capacity, we are committed to working with you side by side. And you'll know that General Langley, Commander, United States Army Africa Command, has just been pushing our Congress to enable us to do that with more urgency. Because we recognize you have a choice. The United States strives to be that partner of choice, a partner who shares your objectives, your commitment to deliver a vision, a shared vision for Africa in the future for the next 40 years and beyond. A partner who shares your values, who recognizes that democracy, whether in the United States or here in the great country of Côte d'Ivoire, is a continual work in progress, but offers the best way to deliver the people's priorities. A partner who listens, and when we disagree, as partners sometimes do, welcome respectful debate. And a partner who delivers the support you require, quality training and equipment with ongoing support and sustainment. I'll finish as I started by quoting my commander-in-chief. The United States is all in on Africa and all in with Africa because we are truly stronger together. Thank you very much.
General Leo. Williams, thank you for your remarks. I now pass the floor to Colonel Chelio.
Merci, mon général.
Thank you, General. We have understood that for to make this possible is to have a common vision, and this took us to Cote d'Ivoire. Ladies and gentlemen, the operational capacity of Ivorian armed forces is one of the key points of his remarks when he was taking office last year. The Minister of Defense of Cote d'Ivoire have defined some priorities, among which the promotion of human resources is key. I'm talking about partnership, collaboration, and training. He therefore placed a high focus on strategic reflections at the national and international level. This is why Cote d'Ivoire participated to the International Summit of Chief of Staff of West Africa last year, and the second edition of FITLOC initiated by Cote d'Ivoire in 2022 and 2023. Ladies and gentlemen, the time has come for us to listen to the Honorable Minister of Defense of Cote d'Ivoire, Téné Ouattara. Your Excellency, Madam Ambassador of U.S. to the Republic of Cote d'Ivoire, Excellencies, dear ambassadors, dear Major General of Armed Forces of Cote d'Ivoire, the Commander of U.S. and Europe Task Forces in Africa, Major General of the Task Forces Europe and Africa, ladies and gentlemen, dear Chief of Staff of Land Forces of Sister Countries, ladies and gentlemen, Head of Delegations, ladies and gentlemen, Major General, Lieutenant General, High rank officials, Officer General, ladies and gentlemen, with all protocol observed, dear friends of the media, without any delay, I would like, on behalf of His Excellencies Alassane Ouattara, President of the Republic of Cote d'Ivoire, Chief of Staff of Armies, and on my own behalf, wish you all welcome for making the movement to Abidjan. I would like especially to welcome the attendance of Land Forces Chief of Staff coming from all African countries, including the special guest partners of Task Forces coming from Europe and Southern America for Africa, SETAF-AF. I'd like to especially commend the commanding officer for Europe, US, led by General Darryl, for the trust he has in Cote d'Ivoire for the organization of this 11th summit. I note with high satisfaction that the operational partnership, which is putting bringing together our nations, is getting stronger. As an example, we had a multinational anti-terrorist initiative, FOOTLOCK, organized in Africa by the special task force from US since 2005, initiative that we patronize. Few weeks ago, this exercise was jointly organized in Cote d'Ivoire and Ghana. 1,300 soldiers from many countries, including 13 countries from Africa, participated to this exercise. Ladies and gentlemen, the African Land Forces Summit, ALFS, is one of the major military events initiated by the US in Africa. this summit is held in rotation in America and Africa is an action platform allowing the stakeholders to design strategies in order to improve security and the stability of African countries faced with insecurity. With regard to the security situation at the global level, the topic this year for the 11th session is to take up the security issues thanks to civil-military partnership is showing the necessity for the nations to readapt their strategies, adopting a global approach, including a multilateral aspect of the fight, including all actors, not keeping the population and the civil society organizations. In fact, the collaboration and the resilience of the population are critical to the success of the land forces actions. The military actions back up with development actions are undoubtedly an efficient tool to fight terrorism. This is why this partnership is truly important between the military and the civilians. It is the main reason why this summit is seen as an opportunity for the high-rank officials of land forces in Africa to design pragmatic solutions, responses which are realistic to deal with the security issues at the national and international level. As far as Cote d'Ivoire is concerned, we committed ourselves in the reform of our defense system in order to effectively respond to the terrorist attack in the northern part. And this reform was translated, among others, by the creation of a northern operational zone with 2,500 soldiers deployed permanently and by the implementation by the government of a development of basic infrastructure and revenue generation activities for the benefit of the population. And we believe these actions are integrating the management of our displaced persons coming from the neighbor countries, countries where terrorism is a huge challenge. It's true that we welcome many Burkinabe nationals. We must note at this point that in the framework of the global fight against terrorism, an international academy for the fight against terrorism, AELCT was established, created thanks to a partnership with Africa. And this academy is also benefiting from the support of the US. And I guess you will be lucky enough to visit this academy, which is aiming at training all the actors involved in the fight against terrorism. Dear participants, I'm very convinced that at the end of your deliberations, relevant solutions and responses will be provided for a synergy of actions in order to deal with the terrorism and to establish a peaceful environment for our populations. Wishing you full success, I declare opened the 11th edition of African Land Forces Summit. Thank you.
Mesdames et messieurs, il y a 30 secondes, le ministre d'État mis à la défense.
Ladies and gentlemen, 30 seconds ago, the minister was opening this conference, including 40 African countries, 5 European, 1 from America, but it's also 5 speakers with 5 commissions which are going to work towards providing implementable and contingency responses. Ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the first phase of this session. We'll go for the group picture, and after we'll have a press conference which will gather the VIPs. This is why we are now inviting you to stand to allow the high table to leave the stage.
Pour la suite, ce sera à la disposition de la commission presse du 11e officiel autour donc des délégations.
So we are now going for the picture with the 46 participants of the delegation, and for the other guests, it will be with the support of the protocol. Your last word.
Proceed to the official photo. I'll ask that the chiefs of defense, land force commanders, and adjutants general, please come to the steps you see in front of me. And Mr. Bert Gillett will help direct us. And then for the senior enlisted leaders, we'll have your group photo immediately following. We should have a standing chart coming to the screen now. Land Force commanders, if you would, please, to the stage. As we're organizing ourselves, I see that some of the members of the press are leaving. In the foyer, there'll be members of our team ready to direct you. And I will note, we will reconvene at 18:30 by the pool for the reception. So I would ask step 4, please take your place. Step 3, if you'd please take your space. During the photos, we kindly ask that we have no additional photography We have professional photographers that will share photos with all participants. Thank you. Please remove your badge, if you would, please.
Trying to, sir, trying to.
Ladies and gentlemen, we do ask that we allow some access for the official photographer, please. So once again, those in front with cell phone cameras, please step aside for a moment to allow space for the official photographer.
May I please ask for the ALFS logo to return to the main screen, please?
Once again, I'll ask if you're using a cell phone camera, please create some space for the official photo. Senior enlisted leaders, please make your way to the stage for your photo. Senior enlisted leaders, please make your way to the stage for your photo. On the screen behind you, you will see the step assignments. Step three, if you'd please take your spot. Once again, our next event is at 1830 poolside. We will keep the logo up if you would like to take personal photos on the stage.
Senior enlisted, we're gonna gather at the stairs and I'm gonna show you where the Buwake room is, where the C-cell event will be for the remainder of the week when we're not in the main plenary hall. Thank you.